Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding non-alignment or multi-alignment written by M.K. Narayanan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very important for political science optional students. Plus this is also important from your essay point of view. Now in order to understand this editorial, we must know about what is meant by non-alignment. Now as far as the non-aligned movement is concerned, it owes its inception to the era, to the beginning of the Cold War. In the Cold War, the world got divided into two halves. The world got polarized. Means one half was the capitalist one and the other one was the communist one. Now these two halves, they were actually building up their military alliances. Now India and certain developing countries, they have eschewed from joining their military alliances. So non-alignment movement, what is meant by this non-alignment movement? It means that developing world wanted to have their own independent foreign policy. So this is the basic tenet of the non-alignment, to have independent foreign policy. Now along with this independent foreign policy, non-alignment means that the developing countries of that time and presently, they support no colonialism, they support no imperialism, they support the sovereignty, they support integrity, they support development. So if you look at this concept in entirety, it actually is a manifestation of egalitarianism. It is talking about independence, it is talking about development, it is talking about no military alliances, it is talking about maintaining the integrity of a nation. Now this non-aligned movement, has it ended or is it on the verge of ending, or has India sacrificed its non-alignment or not? Now when it comes to the basic tenets of non-alignment, presently what we see in the Indian foreign policy, we are entering into n number of agreements. And when we enter into n number of agreements, we generally tend to call these agreements with certain countries as strategic, or we call the partnership with a certain country as strategic partnership. But when we decode the meaning of this strategic partnership, it tells us that just being a strategic partner doesn't mean that we are sacrificing our foreign policy. This strategic partnership or a strategic relationship, it doesn't mean we are entering into any kind of alliance. Very important. So alliance is a kind of a deepened relationship than what we call as strategic partnership. So India is one such nation that has not entered into any kind of alliance, or we have not entered into any kind of entente. We are just into a strategic relationship with the nations. So it is wrong to say that from non-alignment we have moved to multi-alignment. What India is doing, we are just multi-engaging. Non-alignment means that we are not entering into any kind of military alliance. And multi-alignment means we are entering into multi-military alliances. And this is wrong. Now the author of this editorial M.K. Narayanan, he should actually know about the meaning of this alignment and non-alignment, because this non-alignment, it carries with itself the denominator, the weight, the thrust, the force, and the momentum of our defense engagement. Now, what India is entering into? We are entering into a kind of not the military alliances, but the collective military production of the defense material. We are entering into economic relationship with various countries. We are entering into social relationship with various countries. We are not entering into any kind of military alliance. So what is meant by military alliance? A military alliance like NATO, like CNATO, like SEATO. Now these were the military alliances. Now when you look at the present day global picture, when you look at the diplomatic landscape, the current diplomatic landscape, what we witness is a new kind of the military alliances that are about to fructify. Now what are those alliances? The one alliance that is going to be cemented in the days to come, it is the alliance between Russia and China. Now these are the two communist brothers who were having a kind of of military agreement with China, that if somebody would be attacking them, then we will be supported. It's not like that. Such kind of things were in existence during World War I. Such kind of things were in existence during World War II, when we were talking about Berlin, Rome and Tokyo axis, when we were talking about Russia, England and France axis. Now, during World War II, what we had seen that the military alliances were formed and they fought against each other. Now, these military alliances were in existence in the form of Warsaw Pact and NATO after India got its independence. But India is still not party to this. So it is wrong to say, it is very critical to say that India has actually given away its non-aligned stance, because India is still supportive of the idea of democracy. That is the second thing that this idea of non-alignment conveys. And the third idea is maintaining the integrity and the sovereignty of the nations. And India still believes that this should be respected. India has not thwarted the sovereignty or the integrity of any nation. India is not an aggressive nation, and India always believes in negotiation, in talks, and in integration. We don't believe in hegemonizing. We don't believe in belligerency. We don't believe in the military thing. Now, if you look at India's nuclear policy, it clearly conveys that India is possessing the nuclear weapons just for the defense purpose. It is not for antagonizing somebody. It is not from the perspective of being offensive. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. Now this package will give you the classes on GS prelims, GS mains, answer writing classes, India yearbook classes, current affair classes, and economic survey classes. Plus, with this package, you will be getting the test series that will be free of cost with this package. Plus, you will also be getting the free evaluation thing. Now, in order to just have the complete information, you can visit our websites eiasmentors.com and briniki.com. And from today onwards, we've also started with a new program on the website, and that is about the expected prelims and the expected mains questions. And the students who will be taking up their prelims in for the 2016 August, in case they're interested in practicing the multiple choice questions, they can visit briniki.com and they can register on the briniki.com for free, and they can just participate in this program related to MCQs. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Briniki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice time.